Hello and welcome to BucTV News. I'm Casey Craddock.
And I'm Adriana Sumlin. Coming up on BucTV News, ETSU introduced a new meditation space.
And ETSU is changing their recycling process. BucTV News starts now. You've probably noticed big changes to ETSU's recycling process. ETSU and other local communities have struggled to find solutions for recycling plastics, and now ETSU is only accepting plastics 1 and 2. BucTV News reporter Sydney Wright has the story.
Students returning to campus this fall, plastic recycling is limited, numbers 3 through 7 to be exact. Things like plastic bags, egg cartons, and yogurt cups can no longer be accepted. ETSU Director of Sustainability Kathleen Moore spoke about the issue.
We really are now forced to look at our waste. We can't just send it to someplace else and it just kind of goes away. Now it's in our face.
The problem further complicated by a fire at ETSU's vendor, Carter County Recycling Center.
Currently, we are stockpiling it. There's a misnomer that we are throwing it away. We are not.
Now Moore said the vendor is set to start picking up again in 1 to 2 weeks. But the larger problem.
Mainly it's because countries that we used to send all this junk to eventually, all this stuff, just said, we don't want your stuff anymore. Plus there's been a collapsing of the recycling market where the prices are down so low that 1 and 2 are the most valuable plastics. They can easily be broken down and made into other products.
The department offers mixed recycling and student workers sort through it all.
We want to make it as easy as possible for people to recycle so that's not a barrier. So we take care of that at our recycling center.
Moore recommends cleaning any food or tobacco products before recycling and being aware of non-recyclables contamination, as well as reducing and reusing.
To check if your plastic product is recyclable, you can check the number, usually located at the bottom. Remember, the triangular symbol does not mean that it can automatically be recycled. You'll need the numbers 1 or 2.
We need everybody to be involved.
Moore said innovators in the area are working on a solution to bring back plastics 1 through 7 recycling. Reporting for BucTV News, I'm Sydney Wright.
For a list of recyclable products, visit ETSU's sustainability website.
If you're a student who's in need of a quiet place away from the stress of college, you're in luck. ETSU has established a small refuge from reflection, meditation, or prayer. The space is located in Neil Dossett Hall, room 101, and is open weekdays between 8 and 4:30. The meditation room welcomes all faves. For those interested, please contact the Student Activities and Organizations office.
Good news for ETSU students. The Center for Academic Achievement now offers live tutoring.
Sometimes people look at tutoring as just an extra thing that they have to fit into their busy schedules, but really tutoring can save them time in the long run.
Supported by the Center of Academic Achievement is now available online, and students are encouraged to take advantage. All you need to use it is Chrome or Firefox and a microphone to talk to your tutor. To make an appointment or see instructions on how to get live tutoring, visit the CFAA website.
There's no surprise that ETSU is having some renovation going on at the moment. The DP Culp is scheduled open in January of 2020 with some exciting changes. The new building will have a media center, new eating spaces, in fact. The new dining hall is now open, but what about reserving space in the new Culp? Sign-ups to reserve meeting space start in July, but it's not too late to get on the list. For more information, go to the link below.
The Alternative Breaks program is a unique learning experience. Students engage in active service to address some of the most pressing social issues of our time. Throughout the trip, participants take part in educational and reflective activities, as well as service opportunities. Experiences are student-led and allow students to learn about root issues and gain new perspectives. Applications are now available, and the deadline to apply is October 11th. For more information, please contact Lead and Serve at etsu.edu.
In August, the Department of Veteran Affairs made an announcement on the extension of banning smoking to staff hospitals and medical centers. According to Veterans Health Administration directive, this new policy starts in October for employees. However, it will not start till January of 2020. If you want to stop smoking, the Veterans Health Administration has set up programs for patients and employees. For more information, text or call the VA.
Needing some stress relief? Get outside and enjoy a relaxing sunset flow yoga session. This event is hosted by Campus Recreation, Housing and Residence Life and the Department of Sustainability. This event takes place every Monday in September, with the next session being held on the 23rd from 6:45 to 7:45 at the Buck Ridge Clubhouse. Bring a towel or a blanket because it will be in the grass. In case of inclement weather, the class will meet in the CPA Yoga Studio.
Today, ETSU celebrates Native American heritage through art, music, and cultural activities. This celebration is going on at the Quad from 10 till 6 and includes dancing, storytellers, crafts. And this coming Saturday, peace will be celebrated around the world.
That's all for campus news.
Stay.
Next up is national news.
Stay tuned. We'll have national stories right after the break.
Oh, sweetie. Okay, you know what? Let's take off his sweatshirt. Get rid of pictures of him. You don't have to look at him. Goodbye, Dave.
Mom, you don't understand. He's tagged in like 400 of my posts.
I can cut out tags.
No, that's not how it works.
What is a tag?
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care would love to share their first with you.
Meet the Scan, a simple procedure whose mission is to detect lung cancer early.
But I feel fine.
That's great, but you may still be at high risk for lung cancer.
Oh man, that's a new fence.
If you smoke, early detection could save your life. Learn more at savedbythescan.org.
Queen is just my everything.
His smile did it. His smile, his eyes, his knowledge. My landlord, he decided that he wanted me to move based on the fact that I was transgender. Let's just respect people in everyday life for just being human.
New Mexico students could soon have a free ride to a state college if Governor Michelle Lujan Grisham's plan is approved. Marissa Armas reports.
Let's make it free. Right on. Let's make it free.
A free ride to college for every New Mexican who graduates high school and any adult who returns to school at a community college. That's what Governor Michelle Lujan Grisham wants to do. But in order for it to happen, she's going to need the legislature to approve as much as $35 million in funding when it meets again in January.
Given the incredible interest in making college more affordable and accessible, there are a number of legislators that are really excited about this initiative.
Prior to the governor's announcement, we sat down with Carmen Lopez Wilson, the Deputy Cabinet Secretary for the New Mexico Higher Education Department.
The intent of this is to make sure that every New Mexican has access to college.
The program called New Mexico Opportunity would supplement the tuition gap that's left unpaid by federal grants and the state's lottery scholarship. Right now, on average, New Mexico students have to pay between 25 and 40% of their tuition. Tuition to state institutions ranges from $762 to $3,500 a semester. The program would affect about 55,000 students a year. Students we talked to were thrilled.
I'm already in debt as it is, so being out of debt would be one of the best things ever.
Here in New Mexico, there's a lot of people, our minorities don't get to go to school, so I think, yeah, it should really be reconsidered and hopefully pass.
If this passes, it would be the most wide open and inclusive program on free education in the country. Right now, at least 17 other states and more than 350 locations across 44 states have enacted at least partially free college policies. New Mexico would be the second to offer completely free college.
A teen's murder was streamed and recorded by dozens of people watching and did nothing to help, according to police. Raid Benin has the latest.
They videoed his death instead of helping him.
Police say some of the final moments of 16-year-old Cassine Morris's life were recorded on cell phones and streamed on social media.
Kids stood here and didn't help Cassine. They would rather video this event.
Police say dozens of people watched an unarmed Morris get stabbed earlier this week outside of a strip mall in Nassau County, New York, and did nothing to help.
There was several kids here. There's got to be about 50, 60, 70 kids here. We have a handful of kids that have come forward that have identified subjects involved in this. There is definitely more.
Morris was taken to a hospital where he later died. Investigators say the fight Morris was involved in was over a girl.
It's over a common girl and a perception of who she might be dating or who she might be hanging with.
Homicide detectives are now urging and warning witnesses to come forward.
You need to get out in front of this. After I put handcuffs on you is not going to be the time to be helpful for you.
Officials say police presence has now been beefed up around the school and the area where the fight took place. Nassau County put out a statement on the stabbing saying, quote, "If you see someone in serious danger, please use your phone to get help, not likes and shares."
You guys took my brother away from me and my family.
I'm Reed Binion reporting.
An 8-year-old suspect has since been arrested and charged with second-degree murder in the Morris case.
Brian Lehman has your sports news coming up next.
BucTV News will be right back.
Well, Thomas, you've got pre-diabetes, but with more exercise and a change in diet, it can be reversed.
I've tried exercising. It just makes me hungry for bacon.
I love bacon, too. And who really likes to exercise?
Not me.
Me neither.
Nobody. So we're good?
What? Oh, you still have pre-diabetes. Big time.
Hey, you.
Yeah, you. Getting that college education.
What are you gonna do?
Graduate and take some office job?
Be like everybody else?
Or will you dare do something different?
Like be a teacher. You could be my teacher.
You got the skills. The smarts.
Yes, you.
You could be the teacher I never forget.
That'd be cool.
Does that corporate job even have recess?
What are you gonna make of yourself?
What are you gonna make of me?
It appears these hot ashes are about to be dumped, which could possibly start a wildfire. How will Smokey deal with such a hot situation? The garden hose defense. Next, a thorough stir. Then another spray. And finally, feeling if the ashes are cool.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, yes, the selfie. A ritual practiced so frequently with this tribe, but not so much by Smokey Bear.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Welcome back to BucTV News. I'm Brian Lehman with your weekly sports update. Registration for some intramural sports is still open. BucTV News spoke to flag football player Oliver Taylor to get his perspective on why students should consider signing up.
I think intramurals are really fun. It's a great way to de-stress from all the school. School can be really hard, especially the older you get. So I think intramurals is a great way to relax your mind and just go out and have fun with some friends.
Students interested in participating have until October 10th to register. The open leagues are soccer, volleyball, and racquetball. There are also plenty of one-day events to join, such as cornhole, battleship, and sports trivia. Students can register online at ETSU's website under the intramural sports page and are also able to download the IM Leagues app for a schedule of the games. ETSU soccer got some national publicity Tuesday night as the men's team was featured on the SportsCenter Top 10 thanks to goalkeeper Josh Perriman. Hailing from Sheffield, England, the sophomore goalie stopped two consecutive attempts in the second half en route to a 3-0 victory over Presbyterian. After diving to deny the initial penalty kick, Perriman leaped in the air for a spectacular save on the follow-up attempt to preserve the shutout. His performance helped the men's soccer team to its first home victory of the season before they traveled to North Carolina for a Saturday afternoon game versus High Point. Teresa Maleka led the way for ETSU's women's golf team with a 7th-place individual performance on Tuesday afternoon at the season-opening Mercedes-Benz Intercollegiate. Notching her 5th top 10 collegiate finish, the junior from the Czech Republic ended the day with a 3-under-par score of 210 over 54 holes. Maleka's stellar performance made her one of only 10 golfers to finish under par in a 54-hole tournament with an 86-person field. Despite her contributions, ETSU made a 15th-place team finish in the 2-day tournament. Following a disappointing overtime loss to conference rival VMI last Saturday, ETSU's football team is looking ahead to their next opponent, Austin Peay. The Governors will look to establish a winning streak and remain atop their conference after a 48-34 victory over the Mercer Bears, thanks in part to Cordell Jackson's 2 interceptions that were returned for touchdowns. After completing only 17 of 38 passing attempts last week, the Bucks will be hoping for more consistent play from their starting quarterback as they endeavor to get back in the win column and even their record at 2-2. Tonight at Carnegie Hotel, 5 ETSU athletics alumni will be inducted into the university's Hall of Fame. The 2019 class consists of 1995 to 1998 track and field standout Michelle Gregg, 1962 to 1965 football halfback David Holtzclaw, 2002 to 2005 baseball star Caleb Moore, 1988 to 1992 conference basketball champion Calvin Talford, and ETSU all-time football rushing leader Brandon Walker, who played from 1996 to 1999. After the break, Hannah Wallace is here with your latest entertainment news. But first, here's your play of the day. Odell Beckham Jr.'s Thursday night football performance versus the New York Jets.
Life, just in a different place mentally and emotionally. 12, Mayfield wants all of it. What an effort by OBJ! One-handed! Play. In stride, OBJ! He comes back to MetLife and does this. How about it? Odell Beckham Jr. 89-yard touchdown.
I was 0.5 credits away from completing high school and I didn't do it. My support team never stopped pushing for me to be better because they knew who I could become as a person. I've been given an opportunity and I'm just thankful for it.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
Our hearts are made stronger by how we treat others.
Put her there.
The light you share can impact those around you, but so can the darkness.
Later, twerps!
Did Pete saying mean things bother
you? So when you reach out to another person, take a moment to consider how they will feel and let your heart be the key to making a difference. Because of you, someone's entire day, year, or even life can change.
In every heart, there's hope.
One in three adults has prediabetes. One in three. That means it could be you, your favorite brother, your other brother, you,
yes,
your football buddy, your football buddy, you, the boss, the boss's boss. If one in three adults has prediabetes, that means it could be you, your barber, your barber's barber.
Nice work.
Thanks.
You. Your plumber.
Breathe right into your foot.
Your plumber's masseuse.
Yes.
You, your dog walker.
On your left.
Your cat jogger. Or you, your co-pilot. Your co-pilot's co-pilot. While 1 in 3 adults has prediabetes, with early diagnosis, prediabetes can be reversed. Take the risk test at doihaveprediabetes.org to know where you stand.
What to expect when you're expecting.
Like here?
A teenager.
Today, I'm going to show you how to teen-proof your home. First step, hide the car keys. Preferably somewhere they would never look. Challenges will come up. Be ready for them. Hi, honey.
Ready for the...
Mom, you don't use mannequins in the mannequin challenge.
You don't have to know it all to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
Welcome back to BucTV News. I'm Hannah Wallace with your entertainment news. 6 months and $4 million later, the AMC Theater in Johnson City will conclude their renovations. In 2 short weeks, the facility located on 1804 North Rhone Street reveals their revamp. The new amenities include new menu items, plush recliners, new movie screens, updated sound systems, and for guests 21 and up, MacGuffin's Bar. The Johnson City Commission passed an ordinance in June allowing beer, wine, and liquor to now be sold in movie theaters. In the height of streaming services popularity, AMC is giving their best effort to get us back to the theater. Better grab your boots and get ready for Bristol Rhythm and Roots. State Street in historic downtown Johnson City is soon to be filled with the sound of music and visitors from all over the world. The festival is held to honor the legendary 1927 Bristol Sessions. Bristol was designated by Congress as the official birthplace of country music. Visitors may dance in 2 states while enjoying some of the most celebrated roots performers today. This award-winning event is a 3-day celebration with more than 100 acts performing in the heart of the Twin Cities. The festival takes place September 20th through the 22nd. Local music, craft beer, and good eats can all be found at Main Street Brews and Tunes in downtown Jonesboro. Every Sunday afternoon through the rest of September features a different craft brewery along with a rotating food truck. The music lineup this season aims to please, featuring some local favorite groups and singer-songwriters. Reusable custom cups are available this year to help cut down on plastic waste. The food and beer service begins at 4 p.m. with live music from 5 to 7. For a complete beer and music schedule, go to Main Street Brews and Tunes Facebook page. The Johnson City Community Theater presents How I Learned to Drive at its downtown location. This tragic and haunting play takes its audience on a journey into the life of someone who has lived with and is attempting to move on from sexual abuse. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday performances are at 7:30 p.m. while Sunday matinee is at 2 p.m. Now through the 22nd, due to strong sexual themes, parental discretion is advised. General admission tickets are $15. Students and seniors are $12. You can purchase your tickets at www.jccommunitytheater.com. Coming up on your Hollywood Minute, we're going to take a first look at the star-studded murder mystery, Knives Out. BucTV News is back after the break. I'm Hannah Wallace, and I hope you have a great rest of your week.
Harlan was cleaning house.
Everyone in the family has possible motives.
Was Harlan planning on cutting off Joni?
Did he plan to fire Walter?
Is Richard having an affair?
That's some heavy-duty conjecture.
There's a family full of suspects in the latest trailer for Knives Out, the comic murder mystery with the A-list cast from Star Wars The Last Jedi writer-director Rian Johnson. The lies, red herrings, and family dysfunction all hit the big screen November 27th.
As a lifelong comic book fan, it's a dream come true.
Anthony and Joe Russo have directed 4 hugely successful Marvel movies, including Avengers Endgame, the highest grossing movie of all time worldwide. They may not win an Oscar for it, but they'll pick up at least 1 prize this award season, the Motion Picture Showman of the Year Award from the Hollywood Publicists Union. The brothers will be honored at the 57th annual Publicists Awards ceremony in Beverly Hills on February 7th, 2 days before the Oscars. A Latin American love letter from the Rolling Stones. Bridges to Buenos Aires is a previously unreleased concert film from the band's 1998 Bridges to Babylon tour. More than 2 hours of classic rock and roll, remixed and remastered from the live recordings. It'll be available on various digital, disc, and vinyl formats November 8th. In Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.
Mrs. and Mrs. Jimmy and Mindy
Mew. I came from five generations of teachers. Losing my job was the bottom falling out of my world.
Each other stories?
I'm sorry. I'm afraid I don't know that.
Hey, why don't we go find out? Listen.
Do clouds take naps?
I couldn't tell you.
Dad, do stars visit their friends?
Look!
$150/90, $180/111, $160/110. I had a stroke.
This is what high blood pressure looks like. You might not feel its symptoms, but the results from a stroke are far from invisible or silent. If you've come off your treatment plan, get back on it, or talk with your doctor to create an exercise, diet, and medication plan that works for you. Go to loweryourhbp.org.
If I would have followed a treatment plan, I would not be in this situation.
Disaster tips from the objects left behind.
My home wasn't insured, but you can check your insurance policy now to make sure you're covered.
Oh.
My savings are lost, but you can put money aside and plan for unexpected disaster costs.
We're lost forever, but you can scan important documents now so they survive.
Whoa. For more tips on how to prepare, visit ready.gov.
Welcome back to BucTV News. On today's Take a Look at This, a veteran surprises his kids at multiple schools.
And a traffic accident caused a massive dice roll.
Watch a Navy dad in Florida surprise his four kids at three different schools in one day. Might want to grab the Kleenex for this one, people. Senior Chief Michael Forehand is home on a two-week leave from Iraq, where he's been since April. He decided to surprise his four kids, starting with his grade school boys. Then, he went to his teenage daughter's high school.
Daddy!
And finally, he surprised his 11-year-old son, Gabriel, at his middle school.
Your dad's in the back of the cafeteria.
This Navy dad will return to Iraq, but not before enjoying some much-needed and much-deserved time with his wife and kids.
I am so happy that he's home and he gets to be with us and, you know, we get to be a family again.
A truck driver's sharp turn resulted in a spill that rolled roughly 216,000 gaming dice across a Georgia highway. Boxes of the six-sided dice were en route to tabletop gaming company Trivium Studios when it happened. Emergency responders and company officials worked together to clean up the spilled cargo. By the way, since the average roll of two six-sided dice is seven, and the accident spilled approximately 216,000 dice, the company estimated the driver may have rolled a perfect 756,000. Maybe next time he should let it ride.
Yes.
For Take a Look at This, I'm Jeremy Roth.
Man, imagine that, just driving down the interstate and you're seeing about 100,000 dice laying everywhere.
I know, like, did you see all the stuff they had to clean up? I felt kind of bad.
Yeah, I felt bad for those people, honestly. So, are you thinking about going to the football game or anything?
Yes, it's going to be the first game I've been to this.
Oh, really?
Yep, I'm excited.
Hopefully they can get a win.
Me too.
Yeah, that would be nice.